Hey YouTube community, and welcome to the Expose Your Quote series, where we take quotations from the text that you are studying and blow up individual words and phrases in order to analyse them and make interpretations. Your exam requires you to remember quotations by heart. This does not require you to learn every line from all of the texts you've studied, because that would be impossible. You just have to think smart and learn key quotations. Quotations that could be used for a range of possible questions that the examiner may give you, and cover a range of themes and ideas. I use the term explode because it requires you to blow up the language into smaller pieces, for you to work out the meaning of words and phrases and make interpretations. Exposing the quote helps you to pinpoint word classes and really think about the writer's choices of language and effect these individual words have on us as a reader. This time, I'll be breaking down key quotations for Mr. Fezziwick from A Christmas Carol. A Christmas Carol is a novella written by Charles Dickens. The story focuses on the old, mean, penny-pinching businessman Ebenezer Scrooge. At the beginning of the novella, Scrooge hates Christmas and treats everybody around him terribly. On Christmas Eve, four ghosts visit Scrooge. First, the spirit of his old business partner, Jacob Marley, who tells him that he will be visited by three ghosts. The ghost of Christmas past, the ghost of Christmas present, and the ghosts of Christmas yet to come. The ghost of Christmas past takes Scrooge to see Mr. Fezziwick. In his youth, Scrooge was an apprentice for him, and upon seeing him, Scrooge cried in great excitement, conveying to us the fond and happy memories that Scrooge had of Fezziwick. From the moment Fezziwick is introduced, Dickens uses positive language to describe him, showing us that he is the foil of Scrooge. FYI, a foil is a character who starkly contrasts to another character in literature. Like with Fred, Fezziwick is also a foil of Scrooge. So Dickens describes how Fezziwick rubbed his hands, adjusted his capacious waistcoat, laughed all over himself from his shoes to his organ of benevolence, and called out in a comfortable, oily, rich, fat, jovial voice. So, expose the quote requires you to blow up the language into smaller pieces. During this process, you should pick out key words and identify the word class, the denotation, so the meaning of the word, the connotations, what we associate with the word, and the effect it has on us as a reader, also exploring the writer's ideas. So let's start with the word capacious. Capacious is an adjective, so the word class, which means to contain or be capable of holding a great deal. This is the denotation. Connotations means what we can associate with a word or phrase. So in this case, we can associate the adjective capacious with Fezziwick containing a lot of goodness inside of him and having the capability to be kind, thus letting the reader know that Fezziwick is the foil of Scrooge. So let's move on to the organ of benevolence. The word organ is a noun, which is part of your body that has a particular purpose or function. For example, your heart or your lungs. Benevolence is also a noun, meaning to desire to do good and be charitable. At the time that Dickens was writing, there was a clear divide between the rich and poor, with the capitalist class having most of the wealth and power in society. With the Industrial Revolution and development in machinery, some businesses prospered from this. However, it also left many unemployed, leading to poverty, rioting, and slums in large cities. Dickens himself faced hardship and was forced to work in a factory as a child when his father was put into prison for being unable to pay his debts. This made him concerned with the issues of the poor working class in Victorian society. By Dickens describing Fezziwick as having an organ of benevolence, connotes Fezziwick being a vital function for those around him and for the more disadvantaged members of society. As Fezziwick would represent a member of the capitalist class, Dickens may have wanted to highlight to a Victorian reader that the goodwill of the wealthy was important for society. The list of positive adjectives to describe Fezziwick juxtaposes the adjectives to describe Scrooge, highlighting how different the men are. We would wonder how Scrooge came to be such a mean employer, as he didn't learn it from Fezziwick. Dickens may have wanted to show how the capitalist class had a choice what type of person they wanted to be. Kind and generous like Fezziwick, or mean and selfish like Scrooge. Dickens continues to display Fezziwig's kind nature as he invites people into his home for a Christmas party. Dickens uses repetition of "in came," conveying how welcoming he is. You have the housemaid, the baker, the cook, the milkman, a young boy and girl, who we can infer also affected by poverty, as a boy was inspected of not having board for his master, and a girl had her ears pulled by her mistress. The use of the long sentences emphasises the flow of people coming into Fezziwig's home. We can also see that the individuals being welcomed into his home are not people from his own class or background, but those from poverty who may not be able to afford a decent meal. This would make the Victorian reader reflect on who they are as an individual and how they are helping those less fortunate than they are. It also makes us as a modern reader do the same. After Scrooge observes this, Dickens describes how his heart and soul were in the scene and with his former self. He corroborated everything, remembered everything, enjoyed everything, and underwent the strangest agitation. Now it's your turn to try and expose the quote. Use the questions to help you unpick the language used, identifying word classes, denotations, connotations, effect on the reader and the writer's ideas. How's his visit to Fezziwig cause a change in Scrooge? Once you've analysed a quotation at word level, why not try the following question? Explore Dickens' presentation of Fezziwig and how he acts as the catalyst of change for Scrooge. When writing your paragraph, keep the assessment objectives you are being examined on in mind and use them to structure your paragraph. So, begin with AO1 and show your knowledge of the character and the question. Make an inference about Fezziwig, then continue with AO1 and give a quotation to support your ideas and the question, developing your interpretations. Then move on to AO2 and use subject terminology by identifying a technique that has been used. Analyse the effects of the quotation and language used by using word level analysis, the explode the quote method. Then draw on AO3, exploring the context and make connections back to the text, commenting on the writer's ideas and effect he wanted to have on us as a reader. Educated Minds is a community of sharing, so why don't you share some of your ideas with other students in the comments section below. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you haven't already. Turn on your notifications to keep up to date with Educated Minds' videos. Why not follow Educated Minds on Instagram, Twitter and Facebook too? Until next time, see ya!